Hi guys, this is a stop into the Home Goods TJ Maxx store that's closest to me. I tried something a little different than usual. I kind of held my camera at cart level for part of the time, just so that you could see like me walking through the store. Maybe things not necessarily being pointed out specifically, but just to see how this goes. So that makes for a little bit of a longer video. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I appreciate the feedback. So the stores have been having quite a variety of designer purses lately, and they've been having Vera Bradley and just different brands, Betsy Johnson. None of the fun Betsy Johnson purses, though, at least in my opinion. I like the phone ones and like the different like fun, like kitschy ones that Betsy Johnson line has, but I've just seen some like, you know, kind of typical purses from the Betsy Johnson line. So have you guys seen any other more fun Betsy Johnson handbags or wallets in store? Let me know. And it was pretty busy in the purse section when I was at the store. I don't know when they get new items or anything, but this purse section always seems like it's pretty full of handbags. And compared to some of the other stores that I've been checking out lately, this location has a bunch. So and I haven't really seen any new Betsy Johnson jewelry at the stores. They basically have the same like strawberry themed ones, the baking ones. So I'm hoping to see some new stuff from Betsy Johnson at the store. But who knows? You never know what's going to come in stock at the different locations. And they've recently redone the jewelry department. This store still has a jewelry case, but they don't have as much on the outside of the jewelry case in stuff that I like looking at. So, but they do have some higher end stuff. I liked the mermaid earrings. Those are pretty. I thought these little dumplings are cute. I guess they're like squishy. They're stress dumplings. I don't know. I don't know what they feel like or anything, but I thought that was an adorable idea. And they do have some Crocs in store. The, like, you can see there. I've been looking for Harry Potter Crocs because I know that some people have found them at the stores, but I haven't seen any. And I'm in the market for like a half size, like the smallest suitcase, like hard suitcase that you see, like a half size of that. I saw at a Marshall's and I didn't really like the design on it. So I've been looking at the different stores to see if I can find one that I like, because usually when I travel, I have to gate check my carry-on, even though it's a carry-on and it's supposed to be able to, you know, be put under the seat or in the overhead. But the airlines are always making everyone gate check their carry-ons. So I thought maybe if I got a half size of a carry-on that I might be able to keep it with me inside. So I don't know. But they have some fun, you know, stuffed animals, squashmallows, all the things. This line of stuff reminds me of Claire's. I don't think it's Claire's brand, but it definitely gives the feeling of what you would find at a Claire's store. And this store has a pretty big toy section compared to what I see at the regular standalone like TJ Maxx and Marshall stores. In the back of the store now is all this furniture, like little tables and shelves and that kind of thing, mostly. Pretty big variety. So now that Easter's over, it's basically just seasonal, like spring and summer stuff. So I don't think there's anything like specific in decoration, like for bathrooms and stuff to look at. But, you know, they always do have fun bathroom towels and, you know, comforters and pillows and that kind of thing for the different seasons, even if it's not a holiday. So definitely worth taking a look around to see what your store has. Some really pretty pillows and yeah, so here's some spring looking towels, pretty colors, snowflake pillows. I think we're out of the snowflake season most of the way for most of the country. I love these pillows, but I think those were $40, which I thought was pretty pricey for two pillows, and I think that's more expensive than they used to be. So I thought that was pretty. It's a lamp. It's really pretty. I can't imagine how nice it looks when it's lit up. I'm always looking at the clearance section in the store, but I never really find anything that's a really good markdown. Usually it's only a couple of dollars off. I don't know. I'm sure that there's people who know the markdown cycle of the different stores. I just am not aware of it. So whenever I'm in store, I just take a look and see if there's anything that I can't pass up. You know, if I'm looking for something specific and it happens to be on clearance, then I would buy it, but there's nothing I see on clearance that I'm like, oh, this is such a great deal, I should buy it. So they've got plenty of pillows. You know, they have them arranged by colors usually at this location, so quite a variety. Lots of pet beds. What I've noticed is they don't have a lot of cat toys at these stores. I was looking for a cat toy for my daughter's cat, and they only had one kind. Like, she wanted one of the stick ones that has the dangly part, and because that's what her cat likes playing with, but for some reason, they only had one. So, is that something that you guys have noticed? Because I thought that was pretty weird. They have so much for dogs, and only one cat toy. Well, they have the little ones with the catnip inside, but, you know, I mean, like, a legit, like, you know, get your cat to frolic, you know, around and chase the thing. So anyways, this is like the pop culture aisle of the store, and they have some really cute stuff. But I still have been looking for the Golden Niffler bookends. Still haven't found them, but every time I'm in one of these stores, I always check. I keep coming up empty-handed, though. I'm sure I missed them, but, you know, I tell myself that stores get things at different times, so there's always a chance that I might run across it. You never know. So they have some really cute shelves and drawers and different things. Pretty pricey compared to how much I want to spend, but that's just my opinion. And they have more Crocs here. And I didn't even know they had bird cages, but this one's on clearance. I'm not sure where it came from, but I don't remember ever seeing anything for like bird cages or hamster cages or anything like that at the Home Goods TJ Maxx store. They have their end caps arranged by color on part of the store, which was really nice. Some really pretty napkins. They'd be great for crafting stuff with napkins. Not much wrapping paper anymore. There's a lot more napkins than there is wrapping paper. And they have some cute cushions for, you know, outdoors for the patio sets and that kind of thing. Here's a yellow end cap with a cute little bee gnome. A lot of different planters and gardening stuff. It's taking up like most of their seasonal section. So, some cute birdhouses. I'm a sucker for a cute birdhouse or a bird feeder or, you know, bird bath. I love all of them because I love nature and like watching, you know, all the critters out in my yard. These dragons are adorable. I guess they're stone. I didn't try to pick one up or anything, but they're just cute. I loved that gnome. It was so adorable. I don't have anywhere to set it in my yard, though. Like, if it was on a stand or something, or a hanging one, I would have bought it because it's really adorable. More dragons. A lot of faux flowers and faux plants. Those dogs reminded me of Coraline. You guys have watched Coraline, the dead dogs, the dog angels. And I just love the around, I keep calling it the around the world items. I don't know what the line is actually called, but they have a lot of peacock stuff still and more peacock stuff. And just, I don't know. I love how it looks. I think they're really, really pretty. There's quite a bit of clearance stuff in this store, and they have it in several different locations rather than just in one huge section. But I thought this was cute, but it was broken. Anyways, plenty of clearance stuff, just nothing like that I felt I needed to have. I thought this chair was nice. Looks comfortable. There's a aqua colored end cap, a white end cap. Lots of different pretty things for the summer, like underwater themed stuff. A lot of different lanterns, of course, too. Lanterns are always a thing in these stores. They have like a huge variety. So I saw these bookends and they gave me Harry Potter vibes. They were different. There's two different ones and it was the only ones they had, and I really contemplated getting these. But I mean, I could make anything owl, like pretend like it's Harry Potter, but that doesn't mean it is. I don't know. So I decided not to get them. Still holding out for the Golden Niffler. And I only just want one of those. I don't even want the two bookends. I just want the one. Still plenty of gold stuff. So I still think it's a, I don't want to say a fad, but like a style for the season. They have a lot of different mushroom stuff too. I thought that mermaid was so cute. It was pretty heavy though. It's like a stone mermaid with stones or shells in the head. I don't know. It was cute. And I'm always curious if all the stores get these types of things or whether it's only where I live because we have the ocean nearby. I just never know because I don't go to any stores where there's no ocean nearby. So plenty of outdoor decor, planters and cushions and decorations and, you know, all the things that you need for decorating your yard. Now these chess pieces could also be Harry Potter. I loved this container. Doesn't have any drainage, but I love how it had the little mushrooms around it. It's so cute. There's another turquoisey blue end cap. If you're enjoying this video, don't forget to subscribe and like. Your support means a lot. They have some different outdoor dishes and like picnic baskets and coolers and that kind of thing for, you know, going to the beach and having picnics, etc. So that's about, I guess, a cup to drink out of. I don't know. But they have some really pretty glassware at the store. And I love the teapots and the teacup sets. They're so adorable. That's Ray Dunn salsa and guacamole. It's funny that each store seems to have different Ray Dunn stuff. So I've been seeing a lot of like measuring cups that are Ray Dunn. I wanted to get this mug, but I didn't because I don't need another mug. But I found out afterwards that I guess it reveals which house you get into whenever you put hot liquid in it, which is so fun. I didn't know that. I may have been tempted like even more to get it, but I resisted. So plenty of non-Disney Ray Dunn stuff, but also Disney Ray Dunn stuff, and you know, characters like, you know, Ray Dunn always has the different fun characters and that kind of thing. They have lemon themed things, which is great for the season. Noodle bowls are a big thing right now. See, here's more Ray Dunn stuff. Like, just, I don't want to say generic Ray Dunn stuff, but, you know, it's not specifically themed for a character or movie or anything like that. See, is that Ratatouille? Because how adorable is that? I mean, come on. I love these canisters. They're so cute with the mushrooms and the moths or butterflies. Oh, and they have these wagons, which are great for going to the beach and amusement parks and stuff. They have a pretty good variety of them. So I'm heading up to the cash register area where, you know, the temptations all are. So I always like to make sure that I take a look there and don't miss anything that I might not have seen throughout the rest of the store. And, you know, they've got plenty of phone cases and AirPod cases, Hiromi is one of my favorite Sanrio characters, so I always stop and take a look at that. So there's not really anything, you know, new or anything that I noticed up here, but they do have plenty of mushroom stuff, like I said before. Mushrooms, I think, used to be just a fall thing, but now I'm seeing them all year long, which I'm not mad at because I love mushrooms. I think they're fun. Yeah, so if you made it to this far in the video, I appreciate that, but let me know in the comments how you liked this longer content, and I will take that into consideration when I make my future videos. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!